connection we're looking at first is a 5S/45S meter. These come in multiple different types of configurations, so it really requires you to pay attention to what you're looking at before you begin to make your connections. In this case, at first glance, it appears we have three voltages and two currents. But if you'll notice, the white return from the CTs is going through the middle phase. So this is actually going to be a three-wire delta, phase A and phase C, with phase B grounded. Next, we're going to build our site and create our test. If you're not familiar on exactly how to do this, please review the user manual or the training video online that indicates how to do it. We're going to select our meter form as a 5, service is a 3-wire delta, and our service type is a 3-phase 3-wire delta with B grounded, as we saw earlier. Once you have your site built, go ahead and save it and then select the site, and we'll look at how we go about setting up the wiring next. Now that the sites are built, we can do our hookups. Auxiliary voltage should already be connected, black on phase A, neutral tied over to the ground, and of course ground should be connected as well from the Powermaster. Next, we want to hook up our voltages A, B, and C. A and C go on the live voltages, and we connected B to ground. Our current duckbill probes are inserted into A and C. As always, when dealing with energized circuits, you always want to short your test switch, which in turn shorts your CT, before opening your test switch. Install your duckbills and then reclose your test switch. Verify that your infrared detector is connected, and pull up your vector diagram and verify your vector looks correct for the installation you're to use. If you have any doubts, you can select the reference button and verify that it looks like the reference. Now that all your connections have been made, we will begin with our integrated site test. Perform our test. Once it is completed, if everything was satisfactory, we disconnect everything, leaving auxiliary voltage and ground connected until the unit is powered down. Auxiliary power is turned off, then we remove auxiliary power, and finally, ground.